this is the LogicalDOC login screen. LogicalDOC is a web application. The software must be installed on the company server with local storage, and users will interact with the system through the browser. The system supports several languages. In this case, we will use the English language. What we notice after logging in is this simple and intuitive screen. On the left side, we see a tree of folders where you can organize documents into folders and subfolders, similar to the common organization that everyone can find on their PC. At the folder level, it is then possible to define the security policies by attributing different permissions to individual users or groups. An important aspect in the attribution of LogicalDOC permissions, which differentiates it from other solutions, is that in LogicalDOC, the download permission is not linked to the read permission. With read permission, you can click on folders and see their contents in the central window. The grid can be customized to show or hide specific columns, each of which is dedicated to metadata. LogicalDOC is also a data management system, so you can choose which data to display. Also, one of the most important things is that you can select any document, Word, PDF, OpenOffice, etc. We support a wide variety of DOC extensions and instantly preview them in the right panel. If you want a larger preview, you can right-click on the document and view it. If you also have download permission, you can decide to download the document to your desktop. So, for the preview, you don't need the download permission, but the read permission is enough. Consequently, if you need to have company personnel who can only consult, search, and view the documents without downloading them, you just need to give them the read permission and not the download permission. If you want to create new content in folders, you will need the write permission. With this permission, you can click on this icon at the top, drag files from your desktop into LogicalDOC. Or, if you want to scan documents, you can click on this icon. A window will open, from which you can connect to your scanner. You can combine several scans to compose a multi-page file and save them in LogicalDOC in the form of PDF, TIFF, or JPEG. This use of the system allows your collaborators to easily upload the desired files at any time. But if you need to introduce LogicalDOC into an organization that already has hundreds or thousands of documents in shared folders, these manual upload systems are not sufficient. For this reason, an effective synchronization procedure called import from folders is available in LogicalDOC, which allows you to synchronize external folders with the central LogicalDOC repository. Then, you can install LogicalDOC on your server and allow it to import documents from the identified paths. Furthermore, not only the files will be imported, but the tree present in the folder will also be replicated. In this way, in a short time, I was able to replicate the same document organization created over the years in LogicalDOC. Furthermore, if LogicalDOC finds particular metadata attributed to the files, it will be able to load such customizations. Importing from folders, however, differs from manual file upload, not only in that it allows bulk imports, but also in that it allows continuous synchronization of the contents of external folders. Therefore, if a user were to change a file contained in one of these folders outside LogicalDOC, the system would detect these modifications and update the file inside, creating a new version. In fact, if we select any document and click on the versions menu, we can see which versions have been produced over time for the same document. Therefore, every change that occurs is recorded by LogicalDOC. You will also be able to compare the different versions with each other to see what changes have occurred in the metadata or content, and even recover earlier versions. But that's not all. This synchronization will ensure that even personnel who do not have access to LogicalDOC will be able to contribute to implementing the system by continuing to work as they always have, without the risk of damage caused by overwriting errors, deletions, or multiple files. Another important feature is the Office add-in that uses Web Services API and allows users to see LogicalDOC within Office, Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Outlook, Visual, and others as a remote desktop. You can modify documents by selecting them. We see in this case that the selected document is marked as in use within LogicalDOC. So, I will be able to make the necessary modifications. And when I'm finished saving the document, it will become available again in LogicalDOC, updated in the new version. Here, then, is another way to be able to work simply and effectively on documents using Office together with LogicalDOC. Regardless of how we're going to load the documents into the system, LogicalDOC has the indexing function that processes each content and allows an effective full-text search. This can take place on a vast selection of documents, from PDF, OpenOffice, AutoCAD, medical files, and also the scans, thanks to the OCR available in LogicalDOC. This allows us to search for a document from its own content, as we could do with Google, looking for certain criteria. In fact, LogicalDOC will return a ranking of the results that are closest to our search. Also, allowing us a preview of how the search text is present within the documents, we will be able to easily find what we need. Always from the same choice, I will be able to work on the document. In this case, I could decide to send it by mail as a download ticket or as an attachment. Every action performed within the system is saved and tracked. This allows you to have complete control of the system and security. In fact, in addition to the versioning, a chronology is available on each document, which reports, in addition to the changes made, every action performed. In this case, for example, I can see all the times that the document has been viewed or downloaded, or has taken part in a workflow. In other words, every action taken on a document in LogicalDOC creates an event in the history. This feature introduces two other important features of LogicalDOC. The first is the event subscription feature. Let's imagine a manager or a project manager who needs to be notified of any modifications or changes will be able to subscribe to the owners of one or more certain folders. This subscription can also be filtered for particular types of events and not for all. Thus, for each change considered important, he will receive an email from the system or a notification within it, allowing the system to alert him in real time. On the other hand, if you're a system administrator and want to check what happens inside, such as dynamics or activities, you can take advantage of an important feature such as customized reports. From the administration menu, clicking next to Report, you will be able to see each type of event and by whom it was created. You can check duplicate files, But the most important of all, thanks to an external viewer, you will be able to obtain customized reports. For example, in this report, we can see the number of documents created last month. This is a graphical report, but you can also draw traditional ones. In other words, you will be able to obtain important information, such as which users are the most active in the system, or if there are documents that have not been viewed by anyone for a long time, and therefore we can delete them, or if there are users who do not complete the workflows assigned to them in time, so that we can investigate the reason and optimize the process to have the activities completed on schedule. It is, therefore, a very useful analysis system if used correctly. Obviously, a central feature of any document management system is the workflow, which is the way you have to implement your business processes. And in LogicalDOC, you can use it without programming or installing other applications. Everything is integrated and available from the web interface. In administration, you can find a visual editor. In addition, several ready-made workflow models are already available, from more complex models like this one. Or simpler ones like this one, which, for example, represents a simple workflow with two approval steps. In any case, in LogicalDOC, the workflow is a composition of tasks, which represent the work units, connected to each other by transitions, which are ways to complete the tasks and move on to the next step. Each task has a name, can be assigned a color, and you can assign one or more possible participants. And if your need is to coordinate a team of people working on the same document, all you have to do is design the workflow correctly with the right connections and assign tasks to people on the team. If you want more sophistication, for example, you want the system to automatically sign a document that's been approved, or move it to a different folder, perhaps if it's been rejected, or you want a third-party application to be notified of the status change of a specific workflow. In these cases, you can automate these procedures through the automations of LogicalDOC. The automations use a JavaScript language. From within the automations, you have access to the system, and you can do the same actions allowed in the user interface, with the difference being that here you can automate them. Obviously, this is an option, not the classic use, but still a further possibility to create something more sophisticated by automating different aspects of the system. You can find documentation, instructions, and examples in the LogicalDOC manual. Obviously, at every different point in the workflow, when a task has been rejected or approved, or during transitions, you can insert your automations, assigning different automations based on the type of event that's occurred. Workflows also have versions, so you can take advantage of different versions of the same workflow. This is useful if you need a specific workflow today, but after a few months, there's a need to change something to optimize the process, or in case of changes in the organization. In this case, the workflows already started previously will be able to continue their process despite the changes in progress, in order to avoid hitches or jobs left in the middle. The newly designed workflows are not immediately available for normal users, but become so after confirmation by the administrator by clicking on the button above. From now on, they can be started manually or assigned to folders. Let's check. Let's imagine we want to manually start a workflow on this file. Choose a document. Click on the Start Workflow icon, and LogicalDOC will ask me which workflow I intend to start. The workflow has been started. We note that the status of the document has changed in its metadata. The This metadata indicates the name of the current task in which the workflow is located. Right now, all people who can complete this task have been notified via email. In this email, there is the notice to complete the task and also the link to perform an action. In this case, I have these links: approve, revise, reject. And also the list of attached documents with the download link or the vision. In this way, you will be able to receive a notification to your email and carry out an activity directly from it, because those indicated are the same workflow transitions. In this case, I choose revise. Lock will save my action. Task. Next status. As we can see, this new task has a different color. And if we go back to the original document, we can see that the status of the workflow is shown in the same color as the current status. This can be a detail, but very important if we suppose to have hundreds of tasks. It is important to be able to open a folder and see on the side which documents have been approved and which rejected, or in any case, to have easily visible information showing the priority of the different tasks. Therefore, all the people who can complete the task in which the workflow is currently located are notified via an email, but also within the system. By accessing the dashboard and clicking on the workflow menu, they will be able to view the activities to which they have been assigned and proceed with the action through a double click. I can thus check the linked document and do activities on it. I can link new ones. I can see if others have left annotations or leave mine to collaborate with colleagues. I can visually check the status we are in the workflow. And finally, I can carry out an action as I did in the email. In this case, I choose to approve. So, we see that I passed in the approval status. That assigned the green color. And if we go back to our document in the folder, we see that now the status metadata is shown in green. Obviously, this method of starting workflows manually is not preferable in a production system, where it's better not to leave users the possibility to start or choose a workflow, especially if you have many. Normally, you will automate the execution of workflows by defining them within a folder menu, which of your workflows should be triggered when a new document arrives. For example, you may want to automatically start an invoicing process every time an invoice is produced here. You can then choose the type of document that will start the process and choose the workflow to start. Suppose now that this is a folder where documents are automatically imported. You may have people saving files in shared folders in your network, and when invoices are imported into LogicalDOC, after a few seconds, you will have the workflow related to the invoicing procedure started automatically, and the persons in charge notified. In practice, even people who are not users of LogicalDOC could start workflows. This is a very effective option to implement a sophisticated, but also simple, system.